गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई शिल स्टार्ट ए न्यू टॉपिक नोन एज द जावा वर्चुअल मशीन। द जावा वर्चुअल मशीन और इन शॉर्ट JVM इज ए सॉफ्टवेयर व्हिच रिसाइड्स ऑन इट्स ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम वेयर वी वांट टू रन ए जावा एप्लीकेशन। द JVM प्रोवाइड्स द रन टाइम इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर फॉर द जावा प्रोग्राम्स। JVM इज द की कंपोनेंट बिहाइंड द पोर्टेबिलिटी, सिक्योरिटी एंड प्लेटफॉर्म इंडिपेंडेंसी फॉर द जावा एप्लीकेशंस। That means we need not install the JVM separately. It is accompanied with the operating system, and this JVM provides the runtime environment for executing the Java programs. This JVM is the key component behind the portability of Java applications. That means you can run the Java applications in different electronic gadgets such as the desktops, the laptops, the smartphones, the mobile phones, the washing machines, the personal digital assistants, etc. And on top of that, the JVM provides more enhanced security and it's platform independent. That is because the Java applications can run on different operating systems such as Windows 8, Windows 7, the Linux, the Unix, etc. Then when a Java program is compiled, it is first converted into the bytecode instead of machine language. Now compilation means, okay, compilation means checking for errors, okay, and converting a high level language source code into a machine language code. Now since the Java program is a high level language code, so it has to be converted finally into the machine language so that it is easily understandable by the computer. Because computer understands only machine language in the form of zeros and ones. But unlike other programming languages, okay, the Java program, when it is compiled, it's not directly converted into the machine language, okay, that is the high level language source code comprising the Java program is not directly converted into the machine language to be understandable by the computer. It is first converted into the bytecode instead of the machine language. So the bytecode works as an intermediate language between the machine language code and the Java source code. Now as the Java source code gets converted into the bytecode, okay, before being converted into the machine language code, the JVM or the Java virtual machine interprets that bytecode to the machine language at the runtime. Now interprets here means translation, okay. The JVM will translate the code, okay, which is in the form of bytecode to the machine language at the runtime so that the computer can easily understand and recognize the machine language instructions, okay, when the bytecode has been converted into the form of zeros and ones. So just keep in mind that whenever a Java program is compiled for checking the errors, okay, and translating it into the machine language format, it is first converted into the bytecode before getting converted into the machine language format. And the bytecode acts as an intermediate language between the machine language code and the high level source code, which is the Java source code. And as the Java source code gets converted into the bytecode format, then the JVM interprets or translates that bytecode to the machine language, okay, so that the computer can understand that machine language format at the runtime. And this process is also known as the just-in-time compilation. So JVM acts as just-in-time compiler, but originally the JVM was known as an interpreter. So you can say that JVM acts as both a compiler and an interpreter. So the JVM acts as a just-in-time compiler when the Java program is compiled and converted into the bytecode, and then it acts as an interpreter when it translates the bytecode to the machine language at the runtime. So I hope that is clear. Now consider the figure in this slide. In this figure, you can see that the JVM acts as a layer between the operating system and the Java applications. So JVM provides framework and other runtime services like security checks, memory management, etc. to the Java applications. However, native applications written using other programming languages such as C and C++ run directly on the operating system. Note that Java is platform independent, not JVM. Okay, so JVM is not platform independent, only Java is platform independent. There is a separate JVM, okay, for each operating system. In general, we do not need to install JVM separately. It accompanies the operating system. That means whenever you use electronic gadgets such as desktops, laptops, smartphones, PDAs, electronic washing machines, etc., those electronic gadgets comes with a pre-installed operating system, and the JVM accompanies that operating system. So you need not install the JVM software separately on the operating system. So I hope this is clear, and with this I end my presentation here.